Hello, hello, my CRX community and other viewers. Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be assembling and measuring the lower rotating assembly on a D-series block. This applies for almost every D-series out there. These are the main bearings here, and we're going to go ahead and get these put in. So I'm going to clean this area out really well and make sure it's dry, and we're going to do the preliminary fits right now with the Plastigauge and everything. So what I like to do is I'll wipe these off, and these are ALC race bearings. Let's see if we can get that in focus there. Where is it at? There it is. Standard race bearings. So what I like to do is I'll wipe them off to get all the packing grease off of them. And then there's a little tang right here. And what I'll do is I'll align that tang in the groove there, and I'll hold my finger on it, and I'll push on the other side and just slide it on in. And what you want to do is you just kind of want to level it out. Get it right to where it's setting nice and in the middle. Make sure they're all flushed out, which they are. We got them all installed. We're going to wipe the crankshaft off and lay the crank on there. And that, everything, like I said, goes together dry because we're going to do a Plastigauge check on the oil clearances. So let me get the crankshaft wiped off and get it set down in here. Okay, we got the crank set down in there. And as you can see, I got the counterweights pointed up. And that's so that the oil holes are not straight up, because you want to get a flat piece of Plastigauge straight across. You don't want an oil galley messing it up or anything. So now we'll get the rest of the main bearings in the crankshaft girdle. It's the same process. Slide them in with the tang. We'll set that down. Get this thing cranked down. Okay, we have the Plastigauge set up on there. Let's get this in focus. If you see there, we've got a strip of green on each one of the main lobes. And we will place the girdle on very carefully. And go ahead and tighten the girdle bolts down to full torque spec, like you were building the motor. Then we'll remove everything and check the clearances. Okay, we're trying to get it in focus here. Okay, so we set the crankshaft cap girdle, whatever you want to call it, onto the crankshaft and block assembly, tightened everything down with the Plastigauge. And we got a reading. So the object, and I know it's kind of blurry, it's hard to get down in there. Let me try and zoom in and show you guys. The specs are, for this engine, is 0.0013 to 0.0024. And we're aiming for on this Plastigauge. Let me go ahead and get down there real quick. Alright, if you see right there, it's a smeared piece of wax. It's squished out. And our measurement is 0.013 to 0.0024. So that's 0.0015. So a little bit less than that, all the way up to this one. And anywhere in between would be good. So we'll get down there. See if we can good look at that. Maybe too bright. Anyways, you see, you get the picture. It's got to be between these two boxes, and it is. It's a little bit smaller than the white box, and it's bigger than the green box. So that's between 0.0015 and 0.0024, so that's 0.0015. two. And you would check the rest all the way across. Now be aware, sometimes some of the Plastigauge will stick to the girdle side, so check both sides and use your best judgment. And now we have to check the rods. All right, we got the bearings in. We did the same thing, lined up the tab or the little tang and slid it on up. We got the Speed Factory no-notch rods for the D-series. We're gonna do the same thing, put a strap of Plastigauge across the journals, tighten everything down the spec, and check them. Okay, I'm not sure how good this is getting it, but the specs called for no more than 0.002. So we're right at about 0.0015, so we're well within spec for the rods. So do that and check for the rest of your rods, and then you'll be ready to assemble the lower end. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.